Beloved, we welcome you to Wednesday's edition of the Voice of Resurrection Devotional, Fit for the Kingdom. A very poignant, very important message, because God is looking for people. He's called me to end time global harvest. And if God is leading you, if you're a minister, if you have your own ministry, and you want to come under this apostolic network, then you need to let us know. You need to contact us. We have just begun the process for end time apostolic network. We are believing God to bring sons and daughters into it, to be trained in end time global harvest, kingdom establishers, kingdom take us, beloved. We have to rise up and chase all these demons back into the closet, not by political power, but by spiritual power. We need to regain strength by purging ourselves of compromise, of doubt and unbelief, of covetousness, or anything that will be in the way. We need to rise up in the might of God, in the power of the Spirit, to cause the kingdom of God to come to the earth. Many are speaking about Jesus' return and the establishment of his kingdom in Jerusalem. Beloved, that should not be our primary focus right now. Our primary focus is to bring many in the valley of decision into the kingdom, to awaken the lukewarm church, to cause revival to come so that Jesus will come back for his church before we worry about all of that. I'm not saying it's not important, but what is the Spirit speaking right now? Say, the Spirit is speaking expressly that men shall be lovers of themselves in these last days, proud, boastful, disobedient to parents, and on and on and on. You see, we need to counter the spirit of seduction, seducing spirits, and doctrines of devils, the Bible calls them. We need to counter them in Jesus' name. And so I want to continue this journey in Luke chapter 9. I want to read now verse 59. We've talked about the guy who said, Lord, I'm going to follow you wherever you go. And Jesus gave him the conditions. The Bible didn't tell us what happened to him. Excuse me. Verse 59. And he said unto another, follow me. But he said, Lord, suffer me first to go and bury my father. Here is a man who is bereaved, probably grieving. And at such a time, the Lord calls him and says, you follow me. I'm here trying to build an army that will change the world. Beloved, you better know that it is Christianity that brought the light to the world. Civilization, science, the printing press, the light that enlightened men, that we got out of brute force living and all the craziness. And nations developed and treaties and all these kinds of... It is the word of God that brought such decency and morality into life. And the Lord is calling us now to reestablish that same word and bring it back so that the glory of God will return to the earth. Do you feel such a call? Then get in touch with us in Jesus' name. He said to follow me. I remember 13 years ago, that was the first time in my family we ever suffered what looked like a spiritual defeat. My brother, 50 years old, woke up one morning and his jaw was broken and it was cancer of the blood or plasma or melanoma or whatever they called it. Come on, beloved. And even after the bone marrow transplant and all the medical procedures that he went through in England, and all the fasting and all the prayer, he died anyway. And in that process of grief, the Lord tells me, start your own ministry. Wow. That was where this man was. I wonder where you are as you hear this word. I wonder what you're going through. And Satan is distracting you with your moment. And yet God is calling you to sign up for Kingdom Agenda. To stop grieving, to stop pouting, to give up your anger, to give up your laziness, to give up your bitterness, and sign up, follow me. He said, wait a minute, Lord. My father just died. I want to do it, but let me go and bury my dad. See, this is what I was saying that destroyed the church. Because pastors' children were not turning out right. So many things were happening that was not representative of the Lord. And we started preaching now that our marriage and our relationships at home is first before God's agenda. And we created this generation where people will not make sacrifices for God. Everything is about us and about the family. Come on, beloved. God gave you the family. Bring your family with you to serve God. Don't leave your family at home and you're serving God alone. Don't serve God at church and you don't serve God at home. Have a family altar. Have devotions. Pray together. Deal with the issues of life together at home. Bring the word of God to bear in the struggles your children are having as they're growing up as the first family of a church and under attack and judged by people all day long and every day. Bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Bring them with you to church or to your ministry and teach them the heritage of their faith in serving God. I promise you, your children will turn out right. Don't put your own stuff above God. No, beloved. That's a farce. That's the wrong thing people are teaching that has caused this lukewarmness. And people now come to church to be entertained and to be catered to. But yet God said that his house is a house of sacrifice. That's where his heart will be. Not a house where people live as lords, relaxing, and everything is, you know, for you to be catered to. Or you go down the street where they take care of you better. But are you going to die bankrupt? What investment are you making? What sacrifices are you making for the Lord and for his agenda on the earth? Are your children serving God with you? Have you conducted family altar at home? Or you just preach at church? And then when your children rebel and refuse to serve God, you know, they say, see, he put the ministry over his family. No, you should serve God with your family at home and then bring them to church. Bring them to the ministry. Sign them up in God's army. Let them be your first converts. Show them the supremacy of God's kingdom, the greatness of God giving you a place in his army. And what eternal reward that awaits them. Oh, Paul said, I'll run my race. I've finished my course. Now there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord shall give to me, but not to me only, but to all those that love his appearing. Is the gospel still sound in your lips? May God help you understand the gospel. We love you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.